Republican Congressman Mark Meadows and Jim Jordan are calling on Attorney General Jeff Sessions to either step down now or do his job. In a new op-ed, the congressman writing, Attorney General Jeff Sessions has recused himself from the Russia investigation, but it would appear he has no control at all of the premier law enforcement agency in the world, the FBI. Joining us right now is Ohio Congressman and Vice Chairman of the House Freedom Caucus, Jim Jordan, joins us from Statuary Hall. Jim, good morning to you.
Good morning. Good to be with you.
You have called for him to consider stepping down before, but this time there's so much leaking going on somewhere in the Department of Justice or at the FBI, it looks like he's lost control.
Well, yeah, I mean, this whole story last week in the New York Times, four unnamed sources saying that a 28-year-old shooting his mouth off in a bar was the catalyst for the Russian investigation. This is just too convenient, I think, largely to draw attention away from what we believe was the focus of this investigation, what launched it, and that, of course, is the dossier. This is, as I said to someone before, this is kind of like pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. Pay no attention to all this focus on the dossier we've had for a year now. It's really something else. I just don't buy it. So the leaks continue. The document request, just this week they're saying, oh, we're now going to start giving you the documents. Well, that's a good step, but where's that been for the last 6 months? And, of course, we called on a special counsel 7 months ago, and to date, no one, it hasn't been named. So all these things start to build up, not to mention the fundamental fact, why won't you answer our questions when you come in front of the committee?
Right.
One of the central questions I ask him is, did the FBI pay Christopher Steele? Were you paying, were the taxpayers paying Christopher Steele, reimbursing Christopher Steele at the same time the Democrat National Committee and the Clinton campaign were paying him for this dossier? That's a fundamental question, and he would not answer that in the committee hearing we had a few weeks ago.
You know, Congressman, it is extraordinary, though, to think that you've got Donald Trump as the President of the United States. His own Department of Justice has been stonewalling Congress, who simply are trying to get to the bottom of the same thing he wants to get to the bottom of.
A great question. Steve, this is no different than the treatment we got from Holder and Lynch when they ran the Justice Department. We tried to get all kinds of information, fast and furious, all these other issues. They wouldn't provide witnesses, wouldn't give us information.
Well, then who's running the show over there?
Well, that's the scary part. That is the scary part, particularly when you think we called for a special counsel 6 months ago, July we called for it, and think about what we've learned since we first called for it. And all the people, the growing chorus of people who now believe we need a second special counsel, we've learned that the Clinton campaign paid for the dossier. We've learned that Lisa Page and Bruce Orr had all, or excuse me, Lisa Page and Peter Strzok had all these text messages. Mm-hmm. We've learned that Peter Strzok was the agent who changed the exoneration letter from gross negligence, a criminal standard, to extreme carelessness. We learned he was the guy who ran the Russian investigation. These text messages talk about an insurance policy, and we can't take the risk that the people might actually make Donald Trump president. We've learned all that since we initially called for it, and still no movement on a second special counsel. This is something we think is obvious, and the Attorney General should do.
And your message, if he was watching right now, what would you say to him?
I like Jeff Sessions. I just want you to do your job. We expected a different process and treatment and a different Justice Department when you took over. But unfortunately, we're getting the same kind of slow walking on witness access, slow walking on document production. So that's what we want to see happen.
You know, people say deep state, permanent government. Is that what's at play here?
Well, certainly it seems that folks on the seventh floor, remember, the vast, vast, vast majority of the FBI are great people working hard every day. But some of the top people in the Justice Department, Bruce Orr, Peter Strzok, Lisa Page. Okay. Think about all the questions we have to get answered. Why did Jim Baker get reassigned two weeks ago?
Great questions.
All kinds of unbelievable questions we need answers to. That's what we're calling on Jeff Sessions to provide.
Let's see what happens today. Congressman, thank you very much.
Thank you.